Hey guys, so today we're going to be reviewing Joji, probably one of the best foreign films to come out this year so far. So Joji follows a wealthy Indian family that undergoes a family tragedy, and the eldest son Joji uses this family tragedy for his own personal gain, and he's motivated by greed. Some things that I really liked about this film are the characters. Again, Joji, he's kind of like the movie's villain, and you can understand his motive, even though you might not morally agree with his actions. You can also feel some sympathy for him as well. He's someone who is seen as a failure in the eyes of his family, especially his father. He's trying to find success, and he keeps getting knocked back down, and he's just having a really hard time making a name for himself. So, even though you might not agree morally with his actions, you understand his motive, and there is some ounce of sympathy there for him as well. And I think those characteristics just make for a really compelling movie character, and especially, like a movie villain in this case. In addition to that, his older brother, Jaman, is kind of the good conscience older brother. He has a really good moral compass, and he does the right things. And as you could probably imagine with what I explained so far, that leads to him and Joji butting heads, and watching that unfold on screen is pretty exciting and thrilling to see. Now, some things I didn't like about this film is the pacing. This movie is very slow paced. It's about 2 hours long, but it really could be shrunken down to 1.5 hours. There are huge segments or large chunks of the film that could be easily edited out, but they weren't. They were left in the film. So at times, the movie can feel a little dull and feel like it's just slowly pacing along. So I just wish certain segments and scenes were shortened so it could remain engaging throughout the entirety of the film. In addition to that, even though I said that Joji was a fantastic character in this film, as well as his brother Jaman, there are some characters in this film that are just kind of there for plot convenience. They don't have a whole bunch of lines, and they don't really contribute a whole lot to the plot development or plot progression. I wish they had more lines and they played a bigger role in this film. So, yeah, if I had to rate this film 1 out of 10, I'd probably rate this movie a 7.5 or 8 out of 10. It's extremely suspenseful, thrilling, engaging, except for a few segments and parts where it can kind of drag along. It's pretty comparable to Knives Out. I've heard those comparisons from early reviewers. And after watching this film, I can agree. If you like Knives Out, you probably will enjoy Joji. Although I enjoyed Joji much more than I did Knives Out. And Joji is on Amazon Prime, so after this review, if you feel like you want to watch it, go give it a watch. It's pretty accessible for us viewers here outside of India. So yeah, that includes my review for Joji. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and subscribe here for more reviews in the future.